बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम यू आर टू द इंडस्ट्रियल फार्मेसी तेरू क्लास। टुडे इज़ द फर्स्ट क्लास आफ्टर द मिड टर्म एग्जाम एंड ओवरऑल लेक्चर नंबर इज 17th। टाइटल इज प्लास्टिक एंड ग्लास कंटेनर्स एडिड सब्सटेंसेज एंड स्टीवायर प्रोडक्ट। एज यू नो दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग द स्टीवायर प्रोडक्ट्स एंड दैट पर्टिकुलर लेक्चर we will discuss the different container, particularly the plastic and glass container which are used in the stevia products, and moreover in the formulation different additives are used which are found in additive substances in the manufacturing of these stevia products, or in the formulation of stevia products different additive substances will be discussed in today lecture. Dear students, the main objective of this lecture is to learn about the topics of plastic and glass container and additive substances and these sterile products. As you know, we will focus on the sterile products. Dear students, after the completion of this lecture you will be able to learn about the plastic and glass containers. They are used as containers in stevia product and formulation of additive substances. We will discuss the different additive substances including preservatives, antioxidants, solubilizer, suspending agents, buffers, stabilizers and different other added substances relevant to the formulation of the sterile products. These are the substances which are used in the formulation of the sterile products. We will discuss in detail. Before going to discuss the plastic and glass containers or any other containers which are used in the sterile product, first of all we should know about the packaging. That what is packaging? Packaging may be defined as the collection of different components, for example bottle is a component, vial, closure, cap, ampoule and blister. If you collect these different components and these different components are the components which surround your pharmaceutical products from the time of production until its use. In short word, we can say that the collection of different components like bottle, vial, closure which surround your pharmaceutical product, which is termed as packaging. Our packaging is a process of collecting or combining the different components, for example bottle, vial, closure, cap, ampoule and blister. As you know that water is used for the different formulation like solid dosage form, liquid dosage form, and vial are used, and closure is used for closing, the caps are used, and ampoules are used, and blisters are used for packing, the tablets are capsules. These are the components which surround the pharmaceutical product. When we manufacture the products, then we package it in a suitable container. Suitable vial, closure, caps, and fuse or blister, these are combined and collected, combined, and surround the pharmaceutical product that is from the time of production or manufacturing until its use. After that, we will discuss the classification of packaging material, the types of packaging material. There are different types of packaging material. The different types are mainly categorized into three main classes. including the primary packaging, secondary packaging, and tertiary packaging. Primary packaging is the material that first envelops the product and folds it. It is that type of the packaging to which the contents are in direct contact, or to which the products are in direct contact. This is usually the smallest unit of distribution used, and is a package which is in direct contact with the contents. For example, in fuels, if you see the fuels, the contents of the formulation will be in direct contact with the impure. Impure is a type of the primary packaging. Similarly, wires are also one of the example of the primary packaging, which is the smallest unit of distribution are used, and in which the product or the contents of the formulation are in direct contact. Containers, dosing dropper, as you know that dosing droppers are used for the dispensing of some of the formulation. Closures, that is either the plastic or metal closures, which are in direct contact with the formulation. Syringe, strip package, and plaster packaging. These are the different examples of the primary packaging. Remember that this is the first envelopes the product and fold it, and in which the direct contact with the contents. The second type of the packaging material is termed as secondary packaging. It is outside the primary packaging. Perhaps that is used to group primary package together. For example, paper and boards, these are the outside, toward outside of the primary packaging, and cottons are corrugated fibers, and box, these are the secondary packaging. These are not the direct contact material with the contents of the formulation. The third class of the packaging that is termed as tertiary packaging. It is used for the bulk handling, warehouse storage, and transport shipping. The most common form is a palletized unit load that packs tightly into container. That is the tertiary packaging. Remember that it is used for the bulk handling of the formulation of the product, and warehouse storage whenever a bulk amount is to be stored in the warehouses, and for the transport shipping that is used and that is termed as tertiary packaging. After that we will discuss the filling packaging, plastic and glass containers, that how the containers are filled, and we will focus on the filling or packaging of the sterile products. There are different types of fillers used in the filling of the sterile products, including the pressure pump filler. It is often operated semi-automatically and differs from gravity fillers. And remember that gravity fillers will work under the influence of gravity. The flow will be under the influence of gravity. And the pressure pump filler, as the name indicates, it will utilize the pressure, and principally and that the liquid is under pressure. That is differ from the gravity filler. And the gravity fillers, the filling is processed under the influence of gravity and no pressure is applied. and the liquid. It is usually equipped with an overflow tube connected to a receiver to prevent excess filling of the container. The second type of filling, that is vacuum filling, that is commonly used, and tester filling line for large volume of liquid because it is more adaptable to automation. And a vacuum is produced in a bottle when a nozzle gasket makes a seal against the lip of the bottle to be filled. The vacuum that is produced, it draws the liquid, responsible for drawing the liquid from a reservoir through the delivery tube and to the bottle when the liquid level reaches the level of adjustable overflow tube. The seal is mechanically loosened and the vacuum is released. And the vacuum filling is processed under the mechanism of the vacuum generation in the bottle. That is the filling or packaging of the plastic and glass containers in which we have studied the pressure foam filler and the vacuum filling or vacuum filler. A filling equipment for solid, if the sterile solids are used, such as the antibiotics, are more difficult to subdivide accurately and precisely into individual dose container than are liquids. The rate of flow solid of solid material tends to be slow and irregular, particularly finely powdered small granular particles. Flow must be evenly. Packaging of sterile products, there are different materials like glass containers, metal containers, rubbers and plastics materials are used in the packaging. Glass include, it is made up of glasses, tubes are made up of glasses, vials, syringe, dropper and primary packaging. While metals, for example vials, it is made up of metals, it is a type of primary packaging. Rubbers, vials are syringes, plungers, mixing closures, these are primary packaging. And plastic impure vials and syringe dropper, these are made up of the plastic. And before going to discuss the formulation of sterile products or the added substances, let's overview the topic we have studied so far. That is packaging, we have defined packaging and types of the packaging material, primary packaging, secondary packaging and tertiary packaging, along with the example. And after that we have studied about the filling and packaging, plastic and glass containers. In that particular topic we studied the pressure foam filler and the vacuum filling. And filling equipment for solid we have also discussed.